Prior to the 1972 football season, the Drake Bulldogs weren't considered to be possible contenders for the Missouri Valley Crown. But someone forgot to tell the Big Blue. And in 72, the Bulldogs proved they were more than just contenders. Drake returned to Missouri Valley competition in 1972 for a second try for the Missouri Valley Crown. The Bulldogs re-entered the Valley in 71, but could finish no higher than fifth. In 72, however, the Bulldogs put it together for a 4-1 record in the Valley, finishing as co-champions in the Missouri Valley Conference. Head coach Jack Wallace was named Coach of the Year by the coaches of the Valley. 10 players made either first or second team all-conference selection, while 6 seniors signed professional contracts. Now, let's take a look at the 1972 Bulldog season. Amid 81-degree heat, the Bulldogs opened Valley competition with a bang, stopping the charging Buffaloes from West Texas State 40-12. The Bulldogs opened the big game as Mike Samples forces a West Texas fumble, and Bill Stevenson recovers and returns to the 19-yard line. It took only 3 plays from the 19 as Jerry Heston scored from 2 yards out for an early Drake lead. Drake added another 2 points in the first quarter when number 92, Bill Shrimple, threw quarterback Carl Sweet for a loss in his own end zone for a safety. The offense got rolling on the ensuing kickoff. This 4-yard score by Heston capped an 11-play drive. The defense continued to shine as here Stevenson, one of 6 Canadians on the club, sacks the quarterback, makes him fumble. West Texas recovers. The reverse didn't work here for the Buffaloes as outside linebacker Glenn Lott isn't fooled and throws the reverse man for an 11-yard loss. Now Drake forces West Texas to punt, but they even had trouble doing that. The punter dropped the ball, and before he could recover, J.E. Williams had the ball in the end zone. Drake was awarded the ball on the 4-yard line. From there, it took only 1 forward pass from Dennis Redmond to tight end Pete Sulverson, and another Drake TD. Again, it's Shrimple, this time forcing a fumble, then recovering the loose ball himself. This resulted in a 21-yard field goal by Bob Smith and a 34-12 lead. Scott Rainbolt wrapped up the scoring for Drake with his 54-yard interception return for a TD. The final, Drake 40, West Texas 12. One Valley win, but possibly the toughest test next against the Memphis State Tigers. The Bulldogs proved they were big-time football with a jarring 23-7 destruction of the Memphis State Tigers before 21,700 in Memphis. Redmond opened throwing. He completes a 22-yard shot to Rex Perry. The Bulldogs bogged down 3 plays later, so Bob Smith put up a 32-yard field goal and a 3-0 Drake lead. Bulldogs defense got the ball back promptly, and the offense responded. This time, Redmond's pass went for 56 yards to Slade Willis, and a 10-0 Drake lead. Second half action finds Drake ahead 10-7, but Joe McPherson took matters in his hands, blocking this punt, giving the Blue possession. Jerry Heston scored from 2 yards out, and a 17-7 lead. Bill Shrimple strings the quarterback sweep out and drops the runner for a 13-yard loss. The Memphis fans don't like it a bit. This set up a 28-yard field goal by Smith and a 20-7 lead. Drake's defensive interior, Samples and Stevenson, combined to stop the runner for no gain. 8 plays later, the Bulldogs halt the Memphis drive on a 4th-and-2 play, and again it's Samples knifing through to drop the QB for the loss. Smith added a 41-yard field goal with 1 second left on the clock to close out a 23-7 win for the Bulldogs, possibly the biggest win in modern Drake football history. The turning point of the season came during a 54-8 rout of the North Texas State Eagles. The Bulldogs went to 3-0 in the Missouri Valley Conference, but lost their starting quarterback, record-setting Dennis Redmond, due to a knee injury. Nonetheless, the Bulldogs carry on. We pick up the action in the first quarter. On 4th-and-3, Scott Rainbolt, Bill Shrimple, and Glenn Locke gang tackle the Eagle fullback for a 2-yard gain, and after the measurement, the ball goes over on downs. Offensively, Jim O'Connor finds running room and scampers 37 yards for a big first and 10. Three plays later, Smith added a 21-yard field goal, and it's a 3-0 Bulldog lead. In the second quarter, Redmond found Doug Winslow for 18 yards and a first and 10. The Bulldog drive stalled, however, but Smith kicked a 41-yarder for a 6-0 Bulldog advantage. Redmond once again found Winslow, this time for 59 yards and a 13-0 Drake lead. The biggest play of the season came when quarterback Dennis Redmond suffered cartilage damage on this play, forcing the Prairie Village Kansas senior to the sidelines until the season finale. Redmond was on the verge of setting every modern Drake passing record and was high on the list of all pro clubs. The Bulldogs must now group around another leader. The defense picked up in the second half, Glenn Lott recovering the North Texas fumbled pitch. Here, new quarterback Bob Smith hits Jerry Heston for a Bulldog touchdown. Smith also threw for another TD, ran one himself, plus TDs by Mike Pryde and Mark Spivey to close out the 54-8 onslaught. But look out, Bulldogs, the Coyote is waiting and licking his chops. South Dakota scored with just 39 seconds left to take a 28-23 upset win over the third-rated Bulldogs before a full house in Vermilion, South Dakota. Drake found itself trailing in the first quarter 7-0 before things began to happen. Steve Parkhurst found quarterback Tom Eagleman on the splits, forcing the fumble, which Stevenson recovered. 6 plays later, Smith hit Winslow for an 8-yard touchdown. Smith added a field goal for a 10-7 lead at half, but Drake found themselves trailing 21-10 in the fourth quarter. The stage is set for a tremendous rally, with Kenny Ferguson leading the way. The Illinois speedster took the kickoff at the Drake 6-yard line and set sail for a 94-yard kickoff return. The gap was closed to 21-17, and the rally wasn't over yet, as the offense got possession in just 4 plays. Smith gives to O'Connor on the draw, and for the Bulldogs, it's a 15-yard gain. 4 plays later, the Bulldogs were 4th-and-3, and Smith dropped back to pass. Forced to scramble, he fires for Doug Winslow, and South Dakota is called for pass interference. This gives the Bulldogs an automatic first down. 2 plays later, Smith hits his big tight end, Sulverson, for 12 yards and a first and goal. Heston found no trouble in scoring from 4 yards out, giving Drake a short-lived 23-21 lead. South Dakota completed an amazing rally with only 1:39 left. They scored and handed Drake their first setback of the season, 28-23. Freshman quarterback Jonas Sears started his first collegiate game for Drake, responding for nearly 300 yards in total offense, while leading the Big Blue over the Panthers of the University of Northern Iowa 21-14. Sears ran for one touchdown while throwing for another and rolled up 216 yards in the air. Sears got Drake moving late in the second quarter with this 32-yard scramble. Trailing 7-0, the freshman thrower hit O'Connor on a screen, and that went 43 yards for the first Drake score. In the second half, Heston capped a short drive with this 12-yard TD and a 12-7 lead. Sears added a touchdown, and Bob Smith hit a 28-yard field goal to wrap up on the Drake scoring. The defense was tough here. Samples, McPherson, and Lott combined on the stop for no gain. Drake's Scotty Rainbow here makes the tackle for the Big Blue. Again, it's Rainbow, this time stopping the option for no gain. The Bulldogs win it 21-14, and it's time to pack the bags for the Florida Sun and the Tampa Spartans. Sophomore quarterback Freddie Solomon led Tampa to a 24-point second half, posting a 24-7 win over Drake. The Bulldogs led 7-0 at the half, but the Spartans held the Big Blue offense in check, allowing only 18 yards rushing in posting the win before 15,000 fans in Tampa, Florida. In selected highlights, Bill Schrempel forces the quarterback to pitch, while Steve Parkhurst and Kenny Ferguson contain the option for a 2-yard loss. Later in the same series, Tampa was 4th-and-3 at the Drake 9. Drake's Glenn Lott and J.E. Williams combined to make the stop for no gain. Tampa was out of downs, and Drake takes possession. Second quarter action found the Blue defense just as tough. Here, Parkhurst and Joe McPherson stopped the pitchman for a 6-yard loss. Doug Winslow returns a Tampa punt 59 yards for a touchdown, and the Bulldogs get themselves a 7-0 lead. Sears again goes to Salverson, this time for 10 yards, and it's another great first down. The drive ended 4 plays later when this 4th down Sears pass slipped off the hands of Winslow in the end zone. A tough break, but the Bulldogs were going home to face New Mexico State with a Valley title on the line.